If you have different social media accounts and you haven't uploaded your profile picture, in that case, different social media platforms generate profile picture for their users. Today in this video, with the help of pure JavaScript, we will learn how to generate unique user's profile picture. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside that, if I type exclamatory sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this HTML5 boilerplate. For the title, I'm giving generate unique user profiles feature. It's in JavaScript project, so I'm writing JavaScript projects. Within the body tag, let's create main element. And inside that, I'm creating div with class name profile. Within that div, I'm again creating another div with class name avatar. Let's duplicate the same div, and for the class name, let's give comment. Now within the first div with class name avatar, let's create image element for the source. As you can see, in the same folder, I do have image name profile.png, so I'm giving the same image. And within the div with class name comment, let's create s3 heading, and within that heading, I'm giving user's name. And also next to that, let's create paragraph element. Let's give some dummy text. Similarly, next to that, let's create different span tag. And within that, I'll be giving different emoji as icon. But if you want to use different icon, you can take the help of third-party libraries. In Windows, if you press Windows key plus full stop, then you'll get this pop-up window from where you can insert your emoji. Now with the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. As you can see, this is the result. Now let's create a standard CSS file. Just below the title tag, let's give the link for our style.css file. Within the style.css file, in order to prevent browser's default margin and padding, for the universal selector, I'm giving margin and padding of 0. Similarly, let's give box size into border box. I want to change the font family, so for the font family, I'm giving sans serif. As you can see, user's profile picture that is really huge, so let's give the proper width and height for that image. As you can see, that image is within our div with class name avatar. So first of all, for the class avatar, let's give the width and height of 3 rem. In order to make circular shape, I'm giving border radius of 50%. Now let's select this code and duplicate it. For the image, I want to give the same height and width of that parent element. So for that, you can write inherit. This image will automatically inherit its parent height and width. Similarly, let's give same thing for border radius. Now in the browser, you can see this is the exact size that I want. But if you have different height and width at the time, you will get distorted image. So in order to prevent that, let's give object fit to cover. Now for the body tag, let's give the minimum height of 100 vh. And in order to bring that browser's content exactly at the center, I'm using flexbox. So let's try display flex. With the help of this justify content to center, I'll bring my content horizontally center. And with the help of align items to center, it will bring your content vertically center. So you might think like it is not horizontally center. It's because of that paragraph element that we have given within the div with class name comment. So for that, for the div with class name comment, let's give the proper height and width. For the width, I'm giving 24 rem. Similarly, for the paragraph that is within our div with class name comment, let's give the margin top and bottom to 0.5 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 0. Now you can see there is proper space between the paragraph tags, username, and icons. Now let's tell div with class name profile. For the class profile, let's give display flex. Now you can see user profile picture and details, they are in same line. As you can see, there is no proper space. For the div with class name comment, I'm giving margin left of 1 rem. Instead of giving this margin left for the div with class name profile, you could give column gap. That would be better. Now you can see there is proper gap between profile picture and user's details. Now for the div with class name profile, I want to give box shadow. For the x offset, I'm giving 0. For the y offset, let's give 0.2 rem. For the spread value, let's give 0.3 rem. For the color, let's give black color with some transparent value. Similarly, let's give some padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 0.4 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 1 rem. Similarly, you can give border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 1 rem. Now you can see proper box shadow. Now let's select this code and duplicate it. Now you can see between two boxes there isn't any gap. So for the class profile, let's give not pseudo class. and within that let's pass the pseudo class first of type. So I'm giving margin top of 1 rem. It means that except for the first div with class name profile, I'm giving margin top of 1 rem. Now you can see there is proper space between the boxes. Now let's remove this user's profile picture. Instead of that, for the div with class name avatar, let's give the class name no img. When you are giving class name no image for that div with class name avatar at the time for the class avatar. Okay, before giving any style, first of all, within that div with class name no image, we'll give the first letter of user's name. Right now we are giving manually, but later on with the help of JavaScript code we'll give dynamically. So now let's give the background color to crimson. For the text color, let's give white. Similarly, let's give font size to 1.8 rem. As you can see, text is not exactly at the center. So now in order to bring that letter exactly at the center, first of all, let's give text align to center and to bring vertically center. For that, you can give line height. And for the line height, you can give the same value that you have given for height. So in our case, that is 3 rem. Now you can see that letter is exactly at center. I just want to keep it simple. So I am commenting out these codes. Now in index.html file, you can remove this first letter of username. Now with the help of JavaScript code, we will give that first letter of username dynamically. There is very few lines of JavaScript code, so I am using internal JavaScript. So just above the end of body tag, let's create a script tag. And within that, first of all, let's give some event listener for the window. So I am listening to the DOM content loaded. And for the second parameter, let's give arrow function. So with the help of this technique, I want to execute each and every JavaScript code as soon as both HTML and CSS codes, they are fully loaded. So now within that arrow function, let's create a constant variable without avatars. And I'm assigning document.querySelectorAll. Within that, let's select this div with class name avatar along with another class name that is noImage. And let's change that user's name. If I select this code and let's copy and let's paste it down, and also let's change this user's name. I think for that user's name, it's better to give first letters as capital letter. So for that, in the standard CSS file for S3 heading that is within our div with class name comment, let's give text transform to capitalize. So now you don't have to worry about whether that user's name they are in capital or small letter. So in our browser, you can see each and every word's letter they are starting with capital letter. So now in JavaScript code, with the help of query selector all, we are selecting each and every div with class name avatar along with class name no image. Now we have to iterate all these images. So for that, I'm using for each method. So let's write without avatars dot for each. So now we are iterating each avatar that is without image, and within that arrow function, let's create constant variable name. And I'm assigning avatar dot. So what I want to do is that first of all, select each and every div with class name avatar that contains class name no image, and I want to get its parent element that is the div with class name profile, and within that profile we do have S3 heading where we have given user's name. So we want to get that. In order to achieve that, you can write something like avatar dot parent element dot query selector. So we are selecting the S3 heading, and I want to get text that is within our S3 heading. For that, I'm writing dot inner text. Now let me show you in the console. So for that, I'm writing console.log name. In your console, did you see that we are getting each and every user's name? But I want to get the first character of user's name that starts with, and I want to insert inside that div with class name avatar. For that, I'm writing avatar dot inner text is equal to name dot character at, and within that if I pass 0, with the help of this method I'm extracting first character of user's name. Let me pause this video. There might be the case where user's name that might start with white space. So in order to prevent that, instead of this code you can write something like name.trim. So with the help of that trim method, you'll be able to remove all white space that is in the beginning and at the end of your user's name. So now with the help of that avatar.innerText, we are inserting text inside that div with class name avatar, and we are inserting the first character or letter of our user's name, something like this, okay? But you can see the background color that you are getting that is the same. with the help of CSS code. As you can see, I have given the background color of crimson. So now we'll give the different background color with the help of JavaScript code. First of all, I'm creating constant variable color code and I'm assigning. Okay, before that, I want to show you something in the console. In the console, if I write name dot character code at and I'm passing 0, with the help of this method, I'll be able to get character code, that is the number in the console. Did you see that? So now you can copy the same code and paste it there. So for the background color, I want to give hexadecimal color. For that, you have to give hash, and along with that, you can give 6 digits. But in the console, you can see we are getting only 2 digit number. Now with the help of this math.pow, for the second parameter, I can give number of power that I want to give. I want to give 7. In the console, did you see that we are getting huge numbers? But you can see these numbers, they are decimal numbers, but I want to get the hexadecimal number. So for that, you can write something like dot to string, and within that, if you pass 2, that means I'm converting decimal number to binary number. If I give there 8, that means I'm converting it to octal number, and if I give 16, I'm converting this decimal number to hexadecimal number. So if you have knowledge about the hexadecimal color code, at maximum digit you will get the white color, and at minimum digits you will get black color. Lower the number, you will get more dark color. So I want to give a bit dark color. I'm passing there 12. Now with the help of this, I'll be able to get numbers between decimal and hexadecimal number. So I'll be able to get numbers from 0 to alphabet B. Now in the console, did you see that we are getting different number with alphabets? So this is exactly what we want. But you can see there are more than 6 digit. We want only the 6 digit. So for that, it's an string, so I can write dot substr. So now with the help of this method, I can extract part of a string. For the first parameter, I can pass the starting position of string, and for the second parameter, you can pass the length of a string that you want to extract. So for the length, I can give there 6, because I want only the 6 digit number. So now we have created color code. Now instead of giving that background color with the help of standard CSS file, let's call this code. I'm writing avatar.style. Let's paste the code. Now for that background color, instead of that hyphen, let's give capital C, and instead of that colon, let's give equal to. For the hash, let's wrap it inside the double quote. So now instead of that 6 digit number, okay, before that, I have forgot to give that code for that color code variable. So let's copy and paste it there, and in the console, let me show you. Did you see that we are getting 6 digit number? Now instead of that, we'll give color code variable. It's an string, so let's concatenate with the help of that plus, and we don't need this console.log, so let's remove this code. And the browser, you are getting a bit similar color. It's because letter R and S, they are close to each other. So let me show you, what if you have same username? So for that, first of all, let's select this code and duplicate it. And in the browser, there you see that if users, they have same name, we are giving the same profile picture. So in order to make that unique profile picture, as you can see, we have used their for each method when we are iterating that avatars without any image. So at that time, along with that is avatar, you can pass second parameter index data represents the position of that each user's profile image, and that is always unique. And now you can add the same index with our character code. Now in the browser, did you see that we are getting each unique user's profile picture? But if you want to give different color variation, you can change the starting value that we have passed within our substr method. So if I change it to 1, did you see that now we are getting totally different background color? So what if I change it to 2? Okay, I think this is better. So let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. Now once again, what if I change user's name? In the browser, did you see that it's completely working perfectly? So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.